If you have to take the cover off of your brother Carriage, here's what you have to do. First of all, you're going to remove these screws that hold the handle in place. Now, I did get the other one out already just to save time. And then I put it in a little bowl. Now, this is magnetic. If you don't have that, just put it in another bowl. Take the handle off. Then next, actually, I was reading a service manual and it said to take screws off the back here. Well, this machine doesn't have it, or this carriage. But I am pretty sure that these two screws underneath have to be done. Just these two, no other screws. But let me show you. We're going to take the dial off. Now, this just pops up, and there's a screw on there. And this only goes on one way. But you may want to note what number you have on the dial here, so that when you put the dial back, it's exactly the same. You're going to take this screw, and sometimes that screwdriver just isn't good enough. I have to use a little bit larger one. And I'm pretty sure this carriage was never taken apart because these screws are pretty tight. Okay, so the way this was on was like this. This little nub here was down on the bottom, and that's where the arrow, that little part, goes in. So I want to keep those by itself. Then you should be able to just pull that up. Actually, I'm seeing some lint in there, so it's probably a good idea that I am doing this. So there's nothing else in the way here, but the cover is not coming up. So I do need to undo those two screws underneath. And let me put this so that the counter is not going to interfere. So I loosen up that one. If you don't like getting grease on you, put some rubber gloves on. Loosen up that one. Now, these are brass colored, so I know these go underneath. And I can feel the cover coming off as I am unscrewing this. And I do like this screwdriver because it's magnetic. Oh, let me just put it upside down. And it kind of went on an angle there. But it looks like it's still attached. Maybe not. Let me see. Okay. Now the cover should come right off. And because of the tripper, I do have to put it on an angle. Now I don't want to lose this. And if you're going to wash this like I did in the sink with the Singer carriage, you probably want to take off all plastic parts. Maybe take a picture of what is on there. Now, these buttons aren't going to come off. And of course, this is the 830. You do not have the separate two middle numbers there. But basically, that's all it is. So after I wash it, then I go ahead and just in reverse, put the cover back on. Turn it upside down, replace those two screws on the bottom, put the dial back on, put the handle back on, and I'm all set. One thing else I want to point out is with the dial, You see that little nub there? That goes in that circle part, not the middle circle, but the other circle. So what you're going to do is, because I took it out, it put that right towards the post. So I need to put right here, which is past zero, and until you get it pushed down. So having it at four didn't really do any good for me. But this has to be put on just right. And then snap that back on. And there.